God said, Adam, you shall not eat of this fruit. The day you shall eat, you shall do what? You shall surely die. You shall surely die. Prophetically, when God was saying, you shall surely die, the day they ate the fruit, did they die? What died? The garment was removed out of them. Watch this. When the presence of God is in your life, it's even bring a cloth in your life. So what they ate, they removed the presence of God, which the presence of God is the holy garment that Adam was wearing. They had clothes, which was the presence of God. And the moment they ate the fruits, the clothes was removed. And when the clothes was removed, that means their position was removed. That means the authority, the power, the glory was also taken away. The next step, what took place? The Bible said they were rebuked out of the Garden of Eden. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Can these people hear this? Listen, sin has the power to dislocate you from your glorious place into a wicked place. When you can see people enjoying good places in life, either they're in the kingdom of darkness or in the kingdom of light, there is no neutral in this earth. You must submit to one kingdom for you to enjoy the benefit of the goodness of the earth. Either you serve the devil and you occupy wealth, either you serve God and you occupy wealth, both of them, they can give you wealth. So a position of Adam in the Garden of Eden, God has given him, and he spoiled it by removing the garments and remaining naked. And God has to go to the realm of man to create clothes again to cover them. So that means covering is important in life. When you lack covering, you are exposed to demonic attack. So Satan could see the garment of Adam, the garment of Eve, and he admired it. And he said, how can I remove the garment? As long as they have the garment, I cannot touch them. As long as they're still wearing the garments, I cannot touch them. So what am I supposed to do? I'm supposed to lie to them so they can remove the garment, so I can have access to touch their life and to touch their destiny. Ladies and gentlemen, you can be untouchable not because of the oil, not because of a spiritual father, but because of the garments that you are wearing. Listen, you cannot just live anyhow with God and expect to be covered. It will shoot you. It will shoot you. The realm of power, the realm of holiness, is a place to maintain victory forever.